My name is Swapna Vittal Rao Hazare. Today I am going to deliver a lecture for the class SYBSC Credit First from Semester 1 and the Chapter 2. The name of the chapter is Classification System. In this chapter particularly we discuss about the artificial system of classification. We will start with the Chapter 2, the System of Classification. In this chapter there are three systems of classification are given. So out of this, the first classification system, that is artificial system of classification, in this chapter we discuss about this system. So let's see what is meant by artificial system of classification. So first, about the introduction of what is the meaning of artificial system of classification. So you can see the first we just discuss about what is the meaning of classification or the systems of classification. So the arrangement of plants into groups and subgroups is called as classification. So this is the simple meaning of classification, just to organize plants or organism into groups and subgroups. The classification arranges plants in a manner which gives an idea of the sequence of their evolution, because classification also deals with the how these organisms are evolved on this planet. It gives an idea about that sequence of their evolution. Then the system, a system of classification is a particular way of delimiting and arranging taxonomic groups. Then about the artificial system, what is exactly the artificial system? This system is given by the Carl Linnaeus. So many taxonomists proposed classification system on the basis of their own understanding of the plant group, taking into consideration only one or few characters. So this artificial system is a more earlier type of you can say the oldest type of classification system, where the taxonomist or the scientist or the botanist, they just considered any plant character on their own understanding. For that purpose they taken into consideration only few characters, one or two morphological characters only. So such system of classification that does not consider the affinities or relationship of plants with one another is called as artificial system. So this is the meaning, what the classification system which does not consider the affinities or the relationship of the plants with one another. So out of various artificial system, the sexual system of classification given by Carolus von Linnaeus is the most accepted artificial system of classification. Because before Linnaeus, there are certain taxonomists or botanists who gave the classification system based on artificial character. It is not actually the artificial character, but it is called as an artificial character because it does not take into consider all the morphological character. Only one or two few characters are taken into consideration. It again does not include any natural affinities or any kind of relationship between the different taxon. That things are not included. That is why it is called as an artificial system of classification. But out of this various classification system proposed by the different taxonomies, the system, the artificial system given by the Linnaeus, it is most accepted because it is a very large work which is done by that Linnaeus about the classification of plant, because he classified the entire plant kingdom into 24 different classes, and this system we later on discuss. So Carolus Linnaeus, its period is from 1707 to 1778. He was a great Swedish botanist and said to be the father of taxonomy. Why he called as a father of taxonomy? Because of his monumental work in the field of taxonomy, or for in the work work related to classification of entire plant kingdom. So that is why he is called as a father of taxonomy. So this is the picture of Carolus Linnaeus, and Linnaeus created a binomial system of naming plants and naming animals, whereby each species of plant and animal is given a generic name followed by a specific epithet or the specific name. We call it as a species name, with both names being in a Latin. So because he started giving names to the organism or plant, plant by giving two names, that is a binomial system is given or started by him. So because of his great work, he is considered as a father of taxonomy. So he outlined an artificial system of classification in a species Plantarum. The name of the book is Species Plantarum. He wrote that book and completed that book in 1753, wherein he listed and described near about 7,300 species and arranged all these species in 24 classes, mostly on the basis of he considered certain criteria for the classification purpose, that is few characters he considered, morphological characters. That characters are number of stamens, then union, that is adhesion and cohesion of stamens, then length of the stamens and the distribution of stamens. So here he just considered the floral character, but not entire floral character. He considered only the stamen character. On the basis of this stamen character, he classified all the 7,300 species and arranged them into 24 classes. So let's see that these classes were further subdivided on the basis of carpel character. So initially he considered the stamen character for dividing the plants into different classes. Again he divided these classes into subdivided these classes on the basis of next floral character, that is a carpel character or the female character, into orders. And hence the system of classification is also known as sexual system of classification, because here he considered the floral character, and out of this floral character the essential floral whorls are androecium and gynoecium, or that means the stamens and the carpels. He considered the essential floral characters only, or the floral whorls. He doesn't consider the calyx and the corolla, that is the non-essential part of the flowers, or the you can say the floral whorls. So because of this, it is known as the sexual system of classification. This system of classification, though artificial, was continued for more than 100 years after the death of the Linnaeus due to its simplicity and easy way of identification of plant. It is easy because only a few character, only a stamen characters are considered for classification purpose. So it become very simple and easy to classify the plants by considering just simple characters. So that is why to follow this system is become easier for the scientist or other taxonomist. So because of this, this system continued for more than 100 years, even after the death of Linnaeus. So this is about the outline of Linnaeus' system of classification with 24 classes. So how he classified all the plant into different 24 classes. So the first one is, here only the stamen characters are considered by considering its number, its adhesion cohesion, its the length or the length of the stamens. By considering this character, he classified the plants in such a manner. For example, the first class is Monandria. The meaning of Monandria means the flowers with one stamen. Those flowers are included in this group which have only one stamen. For example, Lemna, Serpus. So these are the plants which have only one stamen. Then the second class is Dionaea. The meaning is the flowers with two stamens. So the example is Salvia. In this group or in this class, only those plants are included which are having only two stamens. Then the next class is Triandria, the flowers with three stamens. The examples are Irish or grasses. So here this in the plant, most of the plant or all the plants, they have only three stamens. Then the next class is Tetraandria, the flowers with four stamens. The example are Mentha, Almus. So likewise, Pentandria, which means five stamens. The example is Ipomea or Primula. Then the next class, Hexandria, the flowers with six stamens. The example, Rumex, Alisma. Then next class, Heptandria, the flowers with seven stamens. The example is Aesculus. Octandria. Octa means 8. So here the flowers with 8 stamens. Phagopyra. The example is Phagopyra. Then the 9th class, the name of the 9th class is Enandria. Here the flower contains only 9 stamens. The example is Ranunculus. And the 10th class is Decandria. Here the flowers with 10 stamens. The example for this class is Oxalis. So likewise, the another class is class number 11, Dodecandria. So here the plants which are having 12 stamens, they are included into this Dodecandria group. So the example is Euphorbia. The class number 12, Icosandria. So flowers with more than 20 stamens. If the plants or the flowers have more than 20 stamens, all such plants are included in this class 12, Icosandria. And all the 20 stamens, they are attached to the calyx. So the example is Rosa and Rubus. The class number 13, Polyandria. The flowers with more than 20 stamens, but they are attached to the receptacle. The example is Nymphaea tilia. The class number 12 and 13, they both have more than 20 stamens, but their attachment is different. In class number 12, they are attached with the calyx. The stamens are attached with the calyx. And in the Polyandria, or class number 13, the stamens are attached to the receptacle. So the attachment is also taken into consideration. Then the 14th class is Didynamia. So stamens are didynamous. The example is Osimum or Linaria. Then the class number 15 is Tetradynamous or the Tetradynamia. Here the stamens are tetradynamous. So tetradynamous and didynamous. The meaning of this is didynamous means there are 4 stamens. Out of these 4 stamens, 2 stamens are long and 2 stamens are short. In case of Tetradynamia, there are 6 stamens. Total 6 stamens are there. Out of these 6 stamens, 4 stamens are long and 2 stamens are short. So if such condition is there, then it is included into Tetradynamia. Then Monadelphia. If the stamens are monadelphous, for example Hibiscus. So monadelphous meaning means here the filaments of the you can say the stamens, here the male character, or we can say the male reproductive part, androecium, here all the filaments, they unite to form a common tube and their anthers are free. Because of the formation of common tube, it is called as a monadelphous condition. So if such species are there, all these species are included into Monadelphia. The best example is Hibiscus. Then Didelphia. So the similar condition is there, but the monadelphous condition, it is occurring in two bundles. All the filaments of the anther, they unite to form a common tube and the anthers are free, but such bundles, two bundles are there. So such condition is called as a Didelphia. The example is Clytodia or P. In case of Polydelphia, the class number 18, the stamens are polydelphous. That means there are many bundles which showing the monadelphous like condition, but in many bundles. So the example is Bombax, Hypericum. This is the example. And the class number 19, the Syngenesia. Here the stamens are syngenesious. The meaning of syngenesious, here all the anthers, they are united or they are fused, but their filaments are free. The example is Helianthus, or all the asteraceae member, they show such kind of syngenesious condition. And the Gynandria, the same stamens, they are adnit to the pistil. If they are attached, the stamens are attached to the gynoecium or the pistil, so such plants are included into Gynandria. The example is Calotropis, Aristolochia. So this figure, it shows different conditions. The monadelphous, where the filaments, they unite to form a common bundle and or tube like structure, and the anthers are free. So in diadelphous, the diadelphous condition, there are occur out of 10 stamens, the 9 stamens they unite to form a one bundle and the other one is a single. So such condition is diadelphous. Then in case of polydelphous, there are many bundles like monodelphous neck condition. In syngenesious, you can see here in the picture all the anthers, they fuse or they are united and the filaments are free. And in the next figure is of synandrous. So these are the real pictures of the flowers which show the condition like monodelphous stamens, the example from hibiscus, then the diadelphous stamen. This is from the peak, you can see clearly the one stamen is separate and the 9 stamen they unite to form a common bundle. Then the syngenesious condition in the sunflower, polydelphous condition in the wombax, and the gynandrous stamens in the calotropis. Then the class number 21, monoecia. So here plants are monoecious. So the example are castor and typha. Then the dioecia, the plants are dioecious. That means monoecious means male and female plants are you can say the male and female flower, they were born on the same plant. The dioecious means the male and female flower, they born on the different plant. And polygamia, the polygamous plant means the male and female flower, they born on the same plant. Or you can see the bisexual flowers. So bisexual, the example are mango and sapindus. In case of dioecia, the example is salix. And the class number 24 is cryptogamia. So this class is involve non-flowering plant. So you can see here, Linnaeus classified entire plant kingdom. So out of this, first 23 classes are related with the flowering plants only, the angiospermic plant. And the class number 24, it is related with the lower plants or the non-flowering plants. All the non-flowering plants, we gather them in one class. The all the cryptogamous, which include algae, fungi, mosses and ferns, they are included in this group or class, the cryptogamia. So you can see in the right side there is a picture that given by Linnaeus in his literature. So there are figures are given which shows the different condition, or you can see the single stamen, monandria, diandria, triandria, tetrandria. Again there are monodelphous condition, diadelphous, polydelphous, etc. Then about the merits of artificial system, because every system has some merits as well as demerits. So it is an earlier system, so it has some merits. For example, identification is made easy because of considering only few characters. These few characters can be easily observable. It is very easy for understanding also, or for remembering the character. So that is why the identification is made easy with this type of classification system. And the poorly known plants, they are placed into one classes. So they are not categorized into the different as a fungi, bryophytes, pteridophytes. They are not categorized into different classes. All they are put together into a single class number 24. So if anyone, he is not able to categorize into proper class, or if that particular specimen is not flowering one, so he can be easily add this plant specimen into that class number 24. Then still remains, this system still remains the most stable and accepted system of classification. It has some limitations. For example, artificial system has some limitation. The plants having phylogenetic similarity are placed in a different groups, because in nowadays, later on, after artificial system, there comes a natural system of classification. Later on comes the phylogenetic system of classification. So modern system, it shows some phylogenetic relationship between the different taxa. But in this system, the different organisms, or if we can say that plant taxa, if two plant taxa, they have some phylogenetic similarity, but they still placed into different group. on the basis of just their morphological character. They have some phylogenetic similarity, but because of their morphological differences, they are placed into different groups. So this is a limitation. Then it gives a limited information about plant member. Another limitation is this system has little or no predictive value. If we consider the phylogenetic classification system, it provides some clue about how these plants are evolved or how the different plant taxa are related with each other or how they have some kind of relationship among them. But in this system, we cannot able to predict such things. So that is why it has very less predictive value. And some examples which show how this system has some demerits or some limitations. So the monocotyledons, dicotyledons and gymnosperm, all these are the phanerograms, and they are these plants are not considered separately. Thus the members of dicotyledons and monocotyledons become very close. If we see the modern system of classification, we know that dicots and monocots are different. Even the gymnosperms are totally different because they have the naked seeds. But with this system, they consider all, they are included all, or they are considered similar. So they are not considered separately. So this is the limitation. So the example is, there are certain examples. The gymnosperms were placed in the 14th class Didynamia along with the Labiatae of the angiosperm family. But if we consider these families according to modern system of classification, it shows they are completely different, but they are placed into a single class in this linear system of classification. So this is a limitation. Then in the 6th class Hexandria, flowers having 6 stamens, Alisma, from the Alismaceae of monocotyledon. So Alisma is from monocotyledon, and Rumex, that is belong to Polygonaceae family, it is belong to dicot. So the monocot and dicot, they are included into the same class, class number 6, Hexandria. So there are some many more examples which shows the monocots and dicots, they are put together, and sometimes the monocot, they are placed in different classes. So this is about the limitations of artificial system of classification. Thank you.